that right? Is my assessment right? Do you consider those your kind of passions in life still, wrestling and music?
Rock and roll and wrestling, there are, you know, nothing, I don't think there's anything on the planet that I've been more interested in my, you know, in my life or still am. Rock and wrestling cross over so much. It's basically the same world, whether it's on stage, in a ring, on the road, or in the, you know, in the back, in the locker room or the dressing rooms. The two worlds cross over so much. And when it comes to the genre of entertainment, to me, there's nothing better than rock and roll and wrestling.
When you first started getting big in ECW and you first started developing that name for yourself and you and D-Von became that tag team that everybody was talking about, were there any sort of rock icons or people that you were a fan of that came to you and said that they liked what you were doing?
Back in the ECW days, there were, a lot of, I guess what you call maybe like underground bands, mm-hmm. who were into us that we got word about, like the guys in Madball, mm-hmm. I know were ECW fans. I'm sure that there are others that I know Rob Zombie was, but you mentioned ECW and the music. I don't think that music was more important to any wrestling company than it was to ECW.
Yeah, I think that that's true. And it's funny that you mentioned Rob Zombie too, because I remember when I first watched my first episode of ECW TV, like I had heard about it in magazines. I'd kind of, you know, there was a buzz about this promotion and I found it. It was on in New York. It was on like the MSG network at like 1 o'clock in the morning, but there was a channel in Westchester, channel 55, had it on Friday nights at 8 o'clock, which is like a crazy time for ECW. It didn't belong at that time on at 8 o'clock at night. It was a 1 a.m. show, but it was on at 8 o'clock. And I remember finding it in the TV guide and I was like, no way, there's no way this is it. And I tuned in and the first thing that I heard was the intro to the show and it was Thunderkiss 65. And I was like the biggest White Zombie fan in the world. And from that point on, I was like, okay, I'm hooked. I'm here.
It's so funny because if you watched ECW for the first time and you're listening to that music, you're going to get a feel for what Paul did so well, which was blatantly rip off music that he was not allowed to use, but we used it anyway. And that was part of the whole rebellious nature of ECW and that whole underground movement of pro wrestling that it was back in the day.